Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. This is the last part of my how to farm the fastest with BAM Army. It's going to be a summary of all the 7 topics, 7 videos that I've spoken about. So for those of you who haven't watched the videos, do check it out as it's in a more detailed manner. So I'm just going to do a little summary of all the 7 stuff that I've spoken about. The first one is understanding about loot. I did mention in my video that to know where the location of the loot, you have to look at certain position of the resources. Depending on where they are at, depending on where they are actually located, it's really important to know that, to understand where they are actually situated, so that you go for a certain kind of base, whether you go for the resources in the storages or whether the resources are in the pumps itself. So do check out that particular clip itself. You guys will definitely learn something from it to determine where is the location of the loot, and then after that you guys will be able to figure out where to attack from and how to attack from and whether to even attack that particular base. So the second topic is on target loot. The targeted loot is basically how much loot I set mentally to myself as to whether to attack the base or not to attack. So I did mention in the video that it depends on where the loot is, the location of the loot, and I did emphasize more on how to determine whether to attack it, what kind of amount to go for. And of course, the minimum amount I set myself mentally is 120,000. As for the other resources, Dark Elixir, this and that, I will mention it in my future video. So the next one I spoke about, the third one, is about deployment. This is really important. If you guys want to go and check it out, how I deploy this quickly, it's really important to go and check out the video, because I show a physical view of how I deploy my troops, showing me deploying on my iPad mini. And of course, deploying that fast is really important, as mentioned, because you'll be able to get the resources really quickly and the defenses won't be able to take out your troops as quickly. And of course, I did mention to watch out for giant bombs. If the giant bombs are over there and your troops you deploy too fast, they'll all just get blasted away. So the next topic, the fourth one, I talked about leagues and trophies. So I mentioned certain leagues that a certain town hall level should be at, farming at that particular area. So I did mention in my video certain trophy range that a certain town hall level should be farming at. And I did state in the description below of the video that a town hall 7 should be farming at 1500 to 1600. And a town hall 8 should be farming at 1700 to 1800. A town hall 9 should be farming at 2100 to 2200. Town hall 10 should be at 2500 to 2600. These are more specific locations of where you should guys be farming at. And in my 5th video, I talked about troops and loot penalty. So I did show you guys how to cook your troops and how many troops to bring. So I did mention not to be too specific in the numbers, just having a ratio of 1 barrack cooking barbarian and 3 barracks cooking archers. The rest will be minions and also 4 wall breakers. As for the loot penalty, I said that there's a certain percentage of penalty you actually suffer if you are a certain town hall level above your opponent's town hall level. All the percentages are all in the description of that particular video itself. And I'll put all the links in the description below so that you guys can go and check out any of the topics that I've spoken on. So the next one is going to be on increasing searching speed. So I did mention as to how to increase your searching speed as to nix really quickly, as to find bases in a particular manner. Some factors to determine are such as searching for a specific base, looking at where to see, what to see and how to see, and including how to increase your searching speed. As mentioned, that if you were to increase your searching speed, you will be able to find more bases, see more bases, and of course be able to find more bases with high resources. And as for the last topic that I talked about farming timings, where I mentioned about what kind of timings are good to farm at, the golden hours of what time you should be farming at that particular moment, as it will yield you the most amount of resources during that 1 hour or 2 hours. So you guys should go and check out the timings that I mentioned in the whole entire video and in an explanatory manner why you guys should actually farm during that timing also, as to why the loot is so good during that moment. But just to summarize a bit, basically it's almost during breakfast, lunch and dinner for me. Of course, I did mention in the video that different countries will be at different timings. So I did state in the description below of that video itself that there's a time converter website that I've given to you guys. You guys can go and check it out and convert to your own time zone itself. Definitely, I can't show you guys all the time zone as you guys have been asking me about it also. As some of you guys have also tried out the timings that I've mentioned, and you guys have commented saying that you guys have gotten really, really good loot, as scoring like few million loot in an hour or 2 hours or so. So I'm really happy that you guys have tried it out and worked out for you guys. So yeah, that's it for all the topics that I spoke about on my 7 videos. Before I end off, I'd like to say a few words, which is the first most important thing that you must have to be able to do such hardcore farming is to have time, definitely. So time is an important factor. If you don't have time to even play Clash or whatsoever, then of course it's going to be hard to progress really quickly. But like what I always say, different people have different method and different progress speed. So nevertheless, of course, using my methods will be fast enough and of course improve your farming rates. And the second thing is, if you do not go ahead and educate yourself, which is to go ahead and watch the last 7 videos that I talked about farming itself, I don't think you'll be able to improve and understand how the whole entire farming system works. So if I were you, I would go ahead and understand and watch all the 7 videos so that you get a clearer understanding of everything. To me, the videos that I've made is like tutorials in the school. If you do not go ahead and go for the classes, do not attend them, do not listen to the classes and the teacher in the class, basically you won't be able to understand it. When you sit for the exam, you won't be able to do well. Likewise on Clash, it is important to understand everything fully, otherwise you won't be able to farm like how I'm farming, doing at this particular farming rate. And as you can see, I won't be able to reach this kind of stats, like 2 billion gold grab and 2 billion elixir escapade. And of course, all this requires a lot of time and effort to do so, and of course a little bit of boosting here and there, so that I do not wait too long for the troops to be cooked. But if you guys want to go ahead and farm for max base, this is how I did it, using BAM to farm. And of course, I do have other strategies that I'd like to introduce to you guys next time, as I use a different army to farm specifically only for dark elixir, and also a specific army to farm only for gold and elixir. So stay tuned for them, as I'll be working on the video soon. For those of you who are going to try this method out, do stay in the comment after you have tried it out, and of course telling us how it has fared for you, telling me whether it's good for you, bad for you, or how it has fared for you. So if that's it, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video and wish you guys all the best in farming to max base or even to whatever desired base that you guys want. And clash on.